my generation has never bought drugs in a building. It's against everything we were taught. Like, walking in a building to buy drugs, it just feels like a Dateline episode. The whole way I'm walking, I'm like, this is against your teachings. You're supposed to buy drugs from a man sitting in the woods. I just picture cops in there going, okay, this idiot fell for it. Everybody get ready. Hey, Mike, great idea with the neon pot leaf on the front door. I get inside, and right away they ask me for ID. I was like, ID? I've never used my ID to buy drugs before. Are you putting my name in a computer? Stop that shit. I get inside. Beautiful dispensary girl. She was vaping. She kind of floated by me. I'm like, whoa. I go, hey, I want to get something mild. She goes, you should try this. It's really good. It's car crash. No, I don't want to start there. I want mild. I want fruity pebbles, grilled cheese. Maybe I take a nap. You know, I wake up, I find my vacuum running, and I'm like, oh, look, I achieved a goal. She whips me up a bag of gummies, and she's like, you spent more than $40. You get one of Grandmom's brownies. Grandmom, in my defense, looked like Grandmom. She was on a rocking chair. She was knitting. She looked like she'd bring me soup when I was sick. She didn't look like she was loaded with THC. I get to the car. We killed the brownie. I pulled into traffic. Quickly, the car became a boat. I was losing it. I didn't want to tell. I was like, "What am I? As your captain, you should swim for shore." I had a bottle of water right there I could not get to. I was like, I can't figure this out. I need, the distance is weird. I should have studied parkour. I was afraid to let go of the steering wheel because in my mind, if I did, the car would roll. So I was just like, I'm a captain now. Keep the bow pointed into the wind. I needed her. So I put on my best, I'm not high voice. I was like, how are you doing over there? She looked right back at me and went, I see angels. I go, what are they doing this far out in the ocean? I was losing it. And I swear to you, at this moment, I heard a voice kick in my head and say, you need Mountain Dew. I don't drink Mountain Dew, but I'll tell you what, if the angels suggest Mountain Dew, I'm gonna find it. There was a gas station like right there. I don't know how I got there. I think I picked the car up and danced. I tied it up. She's on the phone. I go, who are you talking to? She goes, we're in trouble. I have to call the cops. I go, call the cops? I think that's who sold us the drugs. And what are you going to tell them? Grandmom and the angels are chasing us? This is Las Vegas. They've had that call 5 times today. I go, look, you stay here. I'm going in for what they told us to get. More importantly, you make the car look like we're not high. Which is a terrible thing to say to someone who's high. She's like, I don't even know what that means. Windows up, windows down. She said, I'll be in the back seat. I've never seen anything crazier watching her try and climb over that. I got to the front door of the gas station, but doors were automatic. I couldn't get in. I didn't feel fast enough. I was afraid I'd get caught in the middle and cut in half. I was shocked because the place was packed. I thought, these are some of the fastest humans on the earth. Only in Vegas, the guy behind the register sees me. He's like, are you high? Do you need help? I was like, this guy needs my information.
Yes!
He jumped over the register. Comes out, he stops the doors with his mind powers. He grabbed my shirt, he yanked me. I left the earth. I was flying. I could feel the air passing me. Aha was playing Take On Me. I landed right in his arms. I grabbed him, I pulled him close. I go, thank you so much, I've been out at sea for days. He goes, are you coming from the dispensary? I go, how do you know that? He goes, because it's right there.